When you learn how to effectively communicate what service design is and what it does, you'll not only do more work that makes you happy, you'll also be finding better clients who appreciate your work. I want to share a quick story of someone who was able to do this and overcome some of the challenges that go along. One of those challenges is that as a service designer, you're often surrounded by people who have no idea about what it is, or even worse, have a completely wrong perspective on it. And then it's easy to cave in, start doubting if you're going in the right direction, give in to the temptation to go with terms that people are maybe more familiar with, like marketing, UX, or business strategy, rather than sticking to what you believe in, and that's service design. Now, I had a conversation with Lina, who runs a leading service design studio in Greece. Lina was a participant in the Selling Service Design with Confidence program, and she faced all the challenges we just mentioned. As a business owner, she of course needs to find clients who are willing to pay for her services, and somehow she needs to convince them of going with something that they are maybe not familiar with and not comfortable with. She didn't want to go with the marketing, UX, or business strategy route. She wanted to stick with service design. So maybe the bigger question here is even, how do you convince yourself to stick with that messaging? I want to share a short segment of the conversation I had with Lina, where she explains how she was able to overcome these challenges. Roll the clip.
Now I remember a project. It was a pitching process, and we were up against digital agencies. So I had a fear of who we are and what their organization is about and how they would see our offering. But, you know, through the pace of the course, I found out, and we did it, that you have to, you know, embrace who you are and show them a different approach. It was amazing because it was in the beginning of the consultancy and nobody had heard of us. And we were up against established digital agencies and we won. Well, the biggest challenge I found in service design was that people would not understand exactly what service design is and why they should engage with it. People were skeptical about service design. They thought of it as something complicated, maybe larger than the project they had in mind, and they were not exactly certain if it would produce a tangible outcome. They thought of it as more philosophical than practical. It was important to solve this because otherwise we would not be heard as a consultancy. Clients would probably address their projects in a different way. I mean, they may call a digital agency or an agency they knew in the marketing field. What I would have missed if I didn't take the course would be that I may not have pursued this positioning for the consultancy after all. I mean, it may sound big, but, you know, when you are starting and you are an independent consultancy, you get to see so many barriers and you may think that, you know, we don't have clients who will listen to what we are offering, what we are saying. But through your course, I got that this is a situation that many face. And you have to gain confidence of who you are, what you can offer, how you can expand business for the organization you work for. Well, I have to say there were times where I was very skeptical about the way we would be going. But this course helped me to just stick to what we thought was best.
It takes courage to stick with what you believe in, and sometimes it helps when you get some support and encouragement along the way, especially when things get challenging. The support and encouragement for Lina in this case came through the Selling Service Design with Confidence program, and she perceived, she persisted, and eventually, like she said, she won. If you want to build your confidence, if you want to stick with what you believe in, with service design, and find clients who appreciate that. I encourage you to have a look at the program and see if it's a good fit for you. You can find the link to the program in the description of this video, and who knows, you might be the next person sharing their story over here.